Hi Cancer, my name is Amber from Mystic Eyes the Journey, and I am back with another channeled message. So if you are Cancer Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or really just want to tap into Cancer energy, then this reading is for you, and I hope it finds you well. So as usual, we have our tarot, we have our oracle decks, and we're going to get straight on into the energy. Now, Cancer, I feel like coming out of Taurus season and moving into Gemini season has taught you about self-worth, right? Standing up and understanding that what you bring to the collective energies, whether that's the collective as a whole, whether that's your work group, your family life, your friend group, your romantic relationships, there's an understanding of the wealth that you bring into these connections, into these arenas or communities, right? And understanding that that worth is non-physical, right? It's not you walk in here with all of these riches, all of these physical things to give out and hand out to people, but just your energy. The energy signature is so kind, it's so compassionate, it's so loving, and it's able to transform the energies of anybody and anything that you walk into. Now, because this comes so naturally to you, and you've embedded, I'm getting that you would have embedded your energy kind of like a crab, right? Going into the sand. It's like embedded yourself into the foundation of the energy. A lot of people are not even aware that it is your energy that is allowing them to move and succeed in different areas of their lives or projects that you're working on together. Again, place it as it resonates. It's going to be different for everybody. This could be in career, love, friendship, community, creatively, right? But there's something that you've come to the realization about, Cancer. This realization that you're at the undercurrent, you're at the base of everything, making people feel secure and loved and supported. And I think that you've, with the help of the Taurus energy, you've learned in this past season that this is extremely valuable. And the same way you hopefully wouldn't go handing out dollar bills to people who are not appreciative of the energy that you give and the gifts that you put forth, you're starting to realize that it's no different doing that with your energy, right? To continuously hand cash to somebody who doesn't appreciate it, who wastes it, who loses it, who treats it like it's nothing at all. That frustration is the same with the energy, right? I feel like it's been taken for granted. And for some of you, it hasn't been acknowledged at all. So, as we move into this Mercury energy, this vocal energy of Gemini, it's like you're going to be zapped up. You're going to get this power behind you that's going to allow you to actually implement and create realities for yourself where you feel empowered but of value. Right, so you're going to start to see transformations in your relationship, in your workspace, in your career that are going to reflect this newfound value within yourself. Okay, so take advantage of this time coming up, this next month or two. Okay, so we're going to go into tarot and see. Look at that. We got the hanged man that wants to flip over but not come out. That's okay. Right, hanged man is all about that different perspective. Right, so I feel like the fact that it wanted to be seen but didn't want to come out is like, you know, we have this shift of perspective, but now we're ready to move forward with that. What can we create with this newfound sense of value? Right, what do my relationships look like when I'm in my power? How do they change? How do they transform? I'm picking up on death card energy. What do we got? We got the Six of Swords, right? That's walking away, leaving something behind, and being guided to a better timeline, a better reality. Okay? Next to that, we have the Two of Pentacles. This is, I'm picking up with this infinity sign here, this idea of reciprocity. What do I mean by reciprocity? I'm picking up on like an understanding of how to move the energy around. I'm hearing it's nothing personal, but I feel like the Cancer Collective at this time is going to be pulling their energy from here and placing it into here, and then pulling it here and placing it into here. What do I mean by this? All right, sorry about that. I had to plug in my camera. But what do I mean by that? It's like just this understanding of if my energy is not being valued over here, then I can pull my energy back. Right? I don't have to keep giving to this source. I can take this energy and move it over here. Right? And this is like unapologetic, this process now. It's nothing personal. Right? I just need to take my energy from here and put it here. What else? Ace of Swords. Yeah, this is that like aha moment. Something just clicks. Right? And I feel like that's exactly what you're going to be doing. Right? But giving yourself that freedom that if, you know, situations, dynamics, workspaces change and evolve and start to value your energy, then of course you can take that energy that you placed over here and return it over here. It's like learning to juggle and move your energy around, right? Just because somebody had it yesterday doesn't mean that they have it today. You choose. What else? What else for Cancer? The Chariot. Yeah, that's your sign, or that's your that's your card, Cancer. This is forward movement, right? Areas that you may have felt stagnated in the past are going to start to move forward. And look at this space in her solar plexus, right? Her power, her personal power shining out and having the forces that allow forward movement, powerful forward movement at her fingertips, right? Cancer, you know now. You know the power that you have. And just because your power is in the yin realm, just because your power is the power of compassion and love, doesn't mean it's not powerful, right? It's extremely powerful. And I'm hearing now they know. Now they know. Now you know, okay? Because when you know, they know. Right, when you're in touch with your own personal power, it exudes out, it shines out. Okay, so now that you know, they know. The Wheel of Fortune. The wheel is going to turn in your favor. As you embrace your worth, the wheel will turn in your favor and you will be on top. Now, this is a really interesting wheel. Because whoever's on top, whoever's on bottom, it's still the same person. And that's kind of what I'm picking up on, your ability to move the energy around. Right? This is the realization, Cancer, that this wheel is yours. It's your wheel. You created this wheel because you have allowed yourself to be the creator of your own life, the creator of your own destiny. This is the understanding that even when you're at the bottom of the Wheel of Fortune, there's still a version of you that's on the top. It's just a matter of being able to shift your energies, to shift your perspectives around in a way that serves wherever the energy is needed at that particular time. And I'm feeling that Cancer is learning how to be really flexible and adaptive. I'm seeing somebody on a yoga mat, so you may be doing yoga and exploring flexibility within your physical body, which is helping you to understand flexibility in all areas of your life. I feel like you're seeing where you have been too rigid in the past. And I'm picking up that maybe it wasn't even your own rigidity. I'm feeling like for some people, the rigidness was people-pleasing tendencies. Feeling like you can't let this person down or you can't let this team down at the detriment of your own self, your own truth. Right? I'm picking up on some throat chakra stuff. Not saying what it is that you feel, not saying what you feel like needs to be said in order to keep the status quo. But with this particular chariot card, it's like, I don't care. I know who I am. I know what I bring to the table. And this is a long time coming here with the Knight of Pentacles. This is slow and steady progress that has brought you here, a culmination of all of the inner work, the shadow work, the light work, the rituals, the full moon I'm picking up, right? All the moon cycles that you've been through have led you to this realization that is going to propel you forward from here on out. Right, with the Seven of Wands here, it's like you're pushing away negativity, pushing away anything that no longer serves you. Right, allowing yourself to take up the space in your life. Right, I'm hearing kind of picking up on this energy of like, it is not appropriate for other people or things to hold a greater space within your life than you. Okay, I'm gonna go into Oracle from here. We got the Rose Oracle by Rebecca Campbell. Innocence, forgiveness, and be gentle with yourself. Yeah, that's that beautiful Cancerian gentle energy, right? I feel like you're forgiving yourself for these past people-pleasing tendencies, right? Now that you see the truth with this Ace of Swords, it's like, oh, you can't unsee it, right? So be gentle with yourself. Understand that you were operating out of a different framework at that particular time in your life. And now you're able to create from this newfound sense of power, held, sureness of the soil, unseen help, support, and community. Yeah, you're about to start attracting. You're about to see the effort, the love, the energy that you have projected out towards others. This is going to start mirroring back to you. Right? The love that you have previously maybe been pouring into friendships, you're going to start to see that pour back into you. Same with relationships, same with work, same with artistic mediums. This shift of your sense of self-worth, it's like a switch. It's like it turned something on or turned something off. Something switched. And now you're in alignment with universal law. It was because on a deep level, you didn't understand your own worth. And therefore, that lack of internal worth that you felt about yourself was being projected or shined back to you through jobs that didn't appreciate your effort, through relationships that didn't appreciate your work and your effort. But now that that shift has happened within yourself, you are now going to see it reflected back to you. This is very cool. Divine plan, wisdom, intelligence within, and destiny. That's what I was picking up before about creating your own destiny, understanding your own power. This is some kind of spiritual intelligence that you have unlocked. You now see your true value. This is beautiful. What is this? Plant yourself here, integration, embodiment, and grounded action. You're going to be able to build off of this foundation. I feel like Cancer has had many false starts, right? Where you get something going and then tower moment. and it falls apart. And Spirit is saying that the reason that it fell apart in the past is because it was not built on the foundation of true value. And now that you understand that, you're able to build stronger and taller and more magnificence. This is beautiful. I love this energy, Cancer. Okay, let's go a little deeper. What's that? Friendship. Okay, so for a lot of you, this is relational. Okay, interpersonal. I am deeply grateful for the gifts of friends. My appreciation for them is endless. Okay, yeah, you're about to see that appreciation being reflected back to you. Because look at this. Look at this card. Okay, this is not... I mean, yes, it's a card of friendship, but this is the same person. This is the same person, right? That understanding that our relationships, our friendships, they are versions of ourselves that are being mirrored back to each other. That's all this is. That's all this is. Yeah, what you give, you're finally getting back, Cancer. Divine patience. Yeah, you've been patient with that Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, you've been patient. My soul brings forth the right conditions and opportunities for me, and the best answers and solutions are delivered at the best times. Right, so I feel like there may be a part of you that is like, gosh, why couldn't I get this sooner? It's happening at the exact right time. Right, because the Wheel of Fortune talks about divine timing. The reason it's happening now is because that's when it's supposed to happen. What's the rush? I'm hearing, what's the rush? Right? Because if we learn everything, then the lifetime is over. Right? If you've learned everything, you don't need to be here anymore. So what's the rush? Let things take their time, take their course. Fearless self-love. Oh my gosh. Whenever I choose to love myself, no matter the circumstances surrounding me, I am practicing fearlessness. That's it. That's it. 22. Right? That love being reflected back to yourself. Fearlessly loving yourself. Fearlessly valuing yourself and not being afraid to walk away from anything that is out of alignment with that, right? That idea of pulling your energy back. Oh, okay, you don't see my value. Okay, well, I'm going to take my energy back and I'm going to place it over here because this is giving back to me. And as you start to move in this way, it's like the people that have become dependent on your energy are going to start to see you for who you really are. And the power and the love that you bring to everyone that you touch, Cancer. So good on you. This is amazing and congratulations. This is a big deal. This is a big shift. And the things that you're going to be able to create within this new energy are going to be able to stand the test of time. This is solid, solid foundation, right? This is the energy within the Taurus season, right? The second house, that house of value. Taurus is all about building that strong base root foundation. Okay. Now Gemini is going to take you into this social energy where you can express this newfound value. And before you know it, we'll be in Cancer season and then you really get to shine. All right, so I'm going to leave that here, Cancer. If this resonated with you, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, comment down below, and until we meet again, thank you so much. Namaste.